Well, first of all, I should say happy birthday.
Oh, thank you. That's true. Big birthday.
And in typical Richard Branson style, it's going to be an understated affair. You don't have any sort of big adventures planned to mark the special occasion, I understand?
Well, I'm a bit of a kite surfer, and my children love kite surfing as well, so they've challenged me to cross the English Channel with them, so nothing completely understated, yes.
Because you hate a challenge, don't you, obviously?
I hate a challenge, yeah. I think it's... I don't understand people who go and do stupid things like that.
And the challenge, I suppose, is going to be coming up with new challenges, isn't it?
I'm fortunate. I don't think there's ever a shortage of good challenges. You know, whether it's launching businesses where I think, you know, Virgin can come in and shake up an industry, or whether it's, you know, trying to build a spacecraft to take us into space, or whether it's, you know, tackling some social problems, which we spend quite a lot of time doing. Life's full of challenges, so no shortage of challenges, fortunately.
And just speaking about the space challenge, I understand it's going to be next year and the whole Branson clan's going to be on the maiden voyage, is that correct?
Yes, I hope it'll be next year. It'll either be the next year or the year after, but the spaceship is finished, the mothership is finished, the spaceport is nearly finished. So we're getting very close, and the test program starts next month. And when I feel absolutely certain that I'm going to be able to bring my kids back, you know, because my wife would never forgive me otherwise, I will. We'll head off into space.
All right. Well, I wish you all the best with that.
Thank you.
Now, we should probably talk about what you're launching here today. It's not your first foray into the Australian financial services industry. What makes you think that this time around things will be better?
Well, last time we launched a credit card, and it was tremendously successful. It was so successful that our partner, you know, I think felt that we might take all that business away from them. So when the contract ended, they ended the contract. So what we're doing is we're coming back this time with a whole range of products. We're basically saying to the big four banks that are now dominating the industry, they've eaten up the other, you know, seven banks, and so there are literally just four big banks. You know, we'll come and keep you honest. We'll come and give you a run for your money. And I think, you know, on the credit card side, I think there are hundreds of thousands of Australians who would love a credit card that is great value for money. You know, with something like 3% less charges than the others, and we don't have any annual charge. And you know, we're bringing the colours back into the credit card business. We used to have seven different colours. The pink's coming back for the girls, just to let you know. Personally, I think I've got my red card.
Pink can be for boys though too, obviously.
Well, see, I like red. Some boys prefer pink and so on. And you know, but we're not just doing credit cards. We're also doing. We're doing a savings account where you can deposit your money, and we'll pay you a lot more money than, you know, the big banks will pay you for your money. You know, we've tied in with our airline, so that, you know, if you sign up for a Virgin Flyer credit card, you're obviously you get points, but you also get a free flight on Virgin Blue, and then if you want to bring your friends on. You know, if your friends use the credit card, or you use your credit cards to buy your friends tickets, they'll get a free flight. You know, we're using our other strengths here in Australia as well.
So what does this push by the Virgin brand say about Australia's banking sector post GFC?
Well, I think that, you know, when you can get rid of all your competition, which the banks have managed to do, the byproduct of that is high prices, and there's no need for the four banks to compete. And I think that they didn't really think that anybody else would be brave enough to, you know, come into this marketplace after the other smaller banks had disappeared. We managed to do a deal with the bank that is the biggest capitalized bank in Australia, Citibank. But most Australians, you know, haven't particularly heard of, and you know, they've aimed more at a sort of a fairly elite market in Australia. So we've got their, you know, their firepower, but we've got the Virgin brand, and I think the combination of the two can be very, very powerful here in Australia.
Okay, but how will your funding arrangements be different for the big banks? Why will you be able to offer better competitive rates on mortgages?
The principal reason we'll be able to offer better rates is the strength of the Virgin brand. I mean, we won't have to spend anywhere near as much advertising as any other new bank that came into the marketplace. But we also we're happier to accept lesser profits. I mean, we don't have to make hundreds of millions of dollars a year to satisfy shareholders. My children, I can already give them breakfast, lunch, and dinner, we've got an airline, so it doesn't cost as much to fly them around the world. So we're able to accept much smaller, profits as a company than the big banks.
That doesn't sound like a great business model.
It has been the Virgin model, since I started when I was 15 years old. We went into the music business. We offered, music at 20% less than all our competitors, and we built an empire on the back of it. We came into the airline business, for instance, here in Australia. We offered tremendous value for money. We built an airline that's got 30% of the market in Australia. And I think Australians have been very grateful, to Virgin for it. And I think, if you look back in 3 or 4 years' time, the Virgin Bank, Virgin Money will be a formidable force in Australia. It will have saved Australians, millions and millions of dollars. And we'll be making a decent return, so a return we'll be happy with.
And it certainly is a model that you've repeated over and over again, particularly in aviation. Virgin Blue just celebrated its 9th birthday. How would you, how would you describe the airline's progress at this stage? You happy with it?
I think that, we started with Virgin Atlantic 25 years ago. Tremendous airline. Still, is very successful from here to London via Hong Kong. We've seen many airlines disappear over those years, and because we've offered a good quality product, it's done well. The same with Virgin Blue. I mean, it started about 10 years ago. It's made decent returns. Most airlines had a hiccup last year. Virgin Blue had a hiccup, but that's the airline business. You're gonna have ups and downs. V Australia, I flew in from America on it this morning. It's a tremendous airline. I mean, it's great quality, and quality always wins through.
Okay. I guess the other thing, if you're going to be headquartering in Sydney and having a superannuation HQ in Wollongong, I understand, what's that going to mean for jobs? How many Australians will you be recruiting?
We will obviously be creating a lot of jobs. I mean, I think initially, we've got 150 jobs going to be created here. And obviously it depends how successful it is, but hopefully there'll be hundreds of jobs, if not thousands of jobs created, over the coming years.
Okay, and what should Australians be excited about on the mortgage front and on the superannuation front?
Well, let me see, I've got my cheat list here. first of all, if you save with Virgin, we'll be giving you 6.75%. And just to compare that, Westpac pay 4.25% and CBA pay 4.5%. So I mean, it's a big difference. We were the first people to introduce no annual fee card a few years ago, and other people have now copied that. But our no annual fee card will be charging 3% less for your annual charges, which again amounts to a lot of money. And then we've obviously got our flyer card, where you'll not only be getting free airline tickets, but you'll be able to collect miles, and there'll be lots of wonderful things you'll be able to do with those miles.
Okay, and why Australia? Is it your second
home? I'd love coming to Australia, so maybe it's my excuse to come down here more often. But
I think these people might be applauding you.
I think Australia is. Australia likes Virgin. Virgin likes Australia, and Australia's been kind to Virgin, and we're very delighted to be kind back.
Fantastic. Okay, and so what's next, aside from, kiting across the English Channel and going into space, what's next for Richard Branson?
Well, I mean, I've got the business ventures I'm doing, but I suppose most of my time is now spent more on social challenges. So, it's, instead of setting up organisations to make money, it's setting up organisations to tackle some of the seemingly intractable problems in the world. So, 2 years ago we set up with Nelson Mandela and Archbishop Tutu, an organization called the Elders, which, and the Elders go into conflict regions and try to resolve conflicts, you know, whether it's Zimbabwe or Kenya or, you know, Israel, Palestine, and, you know, so they, so that's been a fascinating organization to be involved with. We set up a Center for Disease Control in Africa to try to coordinate the attack on diseases. Set up a carbon war room to try to, you know, coordinate the attack, you know, on carbon. So, so a lot of our time, resources and effort are going into those kinds of issues.
We're having a climate change debate in Australia during our election campaign. What's your, what would you urge Australia's position politically on climate change to be?
I think the important thing with climate change is, you know, is for us business leaders to try to come up with alternative sources of fuel that do not damage the environment. So all the profits that Virgin make from our airlines and that the Virgin Group takes out of those airlines, we invest in trying to develop clean fuels. And you know, we've got two fuels, I think, that we can use for airlines in the future, which will not emit carbon. And so I think the energy of governments and business should be, you know, let's replace the dirty fuels with clean fuels. Let's not try to, you know, restrict industry, but let's make sure that industry can, you know, come up with the answers. And I think most likely we can.
So industry to do it themselves rather than government to set a price?
I think it needs a combination of government and industry. It needs government to say, you know, if you come up with a clean car, you won't be taxed. Dirty cars will be taxed. If you come up with clean planes, you won't be taxed, but, you know, dirty planes will be taxed, and so on. So they've got to use the carrot and stick to try to get on top of global warming.
Okay. If you don't mind, I would like to finish off with a little bit of word association.
Okay.
Does that sound okay?
Try that.
First word that pops into your mind when I say big banks.
Trying to be polite. big banks. Fat.
Okay, billionaire.
Billionaire, Trump.
Okay, global financial crisis.
Unnecessary.
Australia.
Fun.
Tony Abbott.
I don't know much about Tony Abbott.
Julia Gillard.
A woman prime minister.